You know, Fire Moth, they had a pretty good run. They survived all the Hershes except for the last one. It's like failing to beat that thing on the last stage of your Elysian Realm run. Yeah, that one. And as much as I want to say that, man, I nearly had that, if only I fought a little harder. There are other factors that I think are not being considered, like how my signets were absolutely horrible, for example. You may be wondering what does this has to do with the point of this video. It's just like how we, looking from the previous era's perspective, wish that the Fire Moth could have fought a little harder to maybe beat the last Hershes. Just in case you didn't know, Fire Moth is the Honkai fighting forces of the previous civilization, the one that precedes the current one that we are going through in the game. I believe there are a moment we can point to that solidifies the fact that Fire Moth will inevitably lose, and that it's just a matter of when. This is what we'll be finding out today. Now, a lot happened in the previous era, so we'll dumb it down to a few important events. The first is the 6th Hersher. According to first-hand accounts, the Hersher, quote, have human emotions, and that made the people trying to take her down hesitate. Reading the files kinda tells us that losses could have been prevented if the people on the Hersher didn't hesitate, but they did, and the aftermath left the humans of that era with less than half of their combat strength. It was a hard-won battle and a tragedy, yes, but it's not quite what we are looking for yet, so let's keep looking. The 7th Hersher was the first time Mantis was invented. It's basically giving someone a Honkai-infused steroid, making the person become a super soldier, but with various side effects. Like for the first Mantis, Kevin, whose side effect includes a sub-zero body temperature. He then proceeded to single-handedly defeat the Hersher of Fire. This event was a major victory, and for the first time, it seems that they had a fighting chance against the Honkai. At least for a while. Maybe it's because the Honkai adapts to what they are currently fighting, but most Hershers that came after Mantis was invented all seems to have an unconventional approach to defeat the previous era. The 8th Hersher binds a word, and to anyone who read it, they will get hit with an attack that sends them into a deep coma. So the Hersher can literally kill you by using memes. Just create a meme around a popular trend, then post it on any meme forum and reaps all the free kills. You can't exactly walk up to the Hersher and stop it because the Hersher doesn't show itself and just keeps hiding in God knows where. The previous era was barely able to actually find and kill it. The 9th Hersher, while still doing things conventionally, was a huge morale blow to the previous era, as the Hersher easily deletes an entire continent along with causing untold amount of suffering to the remaining humans. The 10th just avoids fighting head-on and would rather go for weaker targets like non-combat personnel and crucial infrastructure. The Hersher can afford to do this because they have a number of 1,000. One of the victims that became a part of the Legion includes a person that is dear to Mobius. We'll save this one for another time. The Legion wreaked havoc but was fortunately put down with clever planning from the previous era side. Though limping, the previous era is still far from defeated, but that's about to change. Ever since Mantis was invented, Fire Moth plans was always, we'll find the Hersher, then send in our elite Mantis like Kevin, and then beat it, straight up, simple. Sadly, that doesn't quite work against the 11th Hersher, which was part of the tragedy of binding, an event that basically anyone in Elysian Realm avoids talking about. The reason they called the battle a tragedy was probably because the 13 flame chasers that we see in Elysian Realm were the only survivors who made it back after the battle. The Hersher of binding was relatively weak, but to make up for it, the Hersher was able to create a disabling field that either impairs or just kills anyone inside. So the Hersher who is immune to the field's effect became the strongest thing inside. This was a tough battle for Fire Moth to win. Keep in mind that most of their victories up to this point were won through their sheer power, and this time, sheer power alone will not save them. So the call was made to go all in. Kevin, for the first time, willingly unleashes his power, knowing full well it will kill many of his comrades. And the story doesn't make it sound like the people lost in the action were little, as Elysia berates Kevin for doing this. I'm not saying that it was a good or a bad call, all I'm saying was that a good amount of losses suffered that day was due to Kevin. This event will forever live in infamy in the Fire Moth. As such, it can be seen as the pivotal moment that made them realize that maybe we can't keep this up much longer. This thinking was brought forward when the next Hersher appeared. The 12th Hersher wasn't hostile initially, but nonetheless, Fire Moth detained the Hersher anyway. Now we must understand the paranoia the previous era had towards Hershers, because the last time a Hersher was seen to have human emotions, it allowed the Hersher to use it to cause more losses. So as much as you agree or disagree with their decisions here, it's important that we understand why they chose to do what they did. Anyway, the impact of this action gave the Hersher hatred and resentment, which was released upon her death, and the Hersher basically wiped the rest of the remaining civilization devastation, leaving Fire Moth as the only group of humans left on Earth. This is basically GG. By the time the Hersher was dealt with, it was basically over as it's all downhill from here. Apart from the 13th Hersher, which many people have theorized to be Elysia, you can check out this video I made on this a while back on the top right. Anyway, now about the question on the moment Fire Moth lost, it's pretty clear that both the 11th and the 12th Hersher was the pivotal moments of the previous era. But I would say that after the tragedy of Binding, Fire Moth will never recover and will remain on the back foot for the rest of their time, till the defeat on the moon. And the 12th Hersher were just them digging their own grave. So what do you think? When did Fire Moth lose? Would you say it happened earlier or right at the end? Or is it just a slow grind to defeat? Anyway, that has been it for today, and I'll see you next time.